Hello and welcome to the Daily Transcript Newsroom. Coming up this week in local business news, EGCA's April meeting features an exchange of ideas between San Diego City Councilman Carl DiMaio and San Diego businessman Vince Mudd on how to best fix the city's fiscal woes. The third annual 2011 Biomimicry Conference, a two-day conference that offers the opportunity to consider the solutions nature can offer, begins Thursday at the San Diego Zoo. And the University of San Diego's third annual Climate and Energy Law Symposium will examine emerging law and policy approaches to encourage clean energy. Nationally this week, the usual slew of government hearings and reports are scheduled, but these could be disrupted if there is a government shutdown. As of Friday evening, Republicans and Democrats had yet to crack their budget stalemate. However, there are reports that a deal is in the works. Should business carry on as usual this week, the Commerce Department releases international trade and business inventories for February, as well as retail sales for March. The Treasury releases international money flows data for February and the federal budget for March. There will be Senate hearings on natural gas drilling, tax practices around the world, deficit reduction, and other topics. The Labor Department releases a job openings and labor turnover survey for February, as well as the producer and consumer price indices for March. And the Federal Reserve releases the Beige Book and industrial production for March. Earnings reports will go ahead as scheduled, no matter what happens in Washington. Alcoa, JPMorgan Chase, Hasbro, Google, Bank of America, Charles Schwab, and Mattel are all releasing financial results. Close up, Dan Johnson, an environmental consultant who heads up the San Diego offices of SCS Engineers, talks about surviving tough economic times. In real estate, when you include distressed sales, home prices in the San Diego, Carlsbad, San Marcos core-based statistical area declined by 5.29% in February compared to the same time period last year, according to business information provider. And George Chamberlain writes about Sempra Energy's planned wind project on the southeastern region of the Hawaiian island of Maui. For more on our stories, check out the rest of SDDT.com. I'm Elizabeth Malloy, and thanks for clicking.